Oh, this is very cool. I'm talking to somebody in Dubuque, Iowa. Is it Iowa or Iowa? How do you say it?
It's Iowa. It's definitely.
It's not Iowa. Okay, it's Iowa. Okay, good, good, good. Thanks for checking that out.
But yeah, come on, Bobby. I mean, it's.
I hear it's pretty flat there.
Yeah, Iowa. Yeah, there's a lot of corn.
Oh, that's
there's,
cool.
There's just corn. A lot of corn.
I love corn. Corn's great.
I don't think bears really like corn, do they?
I do. I'm not like every other bear. Talking bears are a little different than the, you know, than a lot of the bears you know. So you wanted to talk about youth, right?
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So I'm super passionate about helping the youth. It's not something that I do for a living. It's more or less something that I do really just to feed my passion. I had a rough upbringing.
Oh, wow.
And so I talk. Yeah, anytime that I get to reach out and help, so I'm big with volunteering with Junior Achievement, which is a nonprofit here in the States where you go in and you help like teach a class in the fall. So I do a class in the fall and I do another one in the spring.
So you get to help those kids that have trouble like you had when you were young, right? So that helps heal that, right?
Yeah, I think it's a really good way to – It's relatable, and I'm still young, so I think that when I'm talking to them, especially like the high school, college age, instead of just being like somebody who's there to talk to them to try to tell them how to be a grown up, it's somebody who's young enough to relate to them. Does that make sense?
Yeah, totally makes sense. So, what's been the most interesting thing that's happened when you've been doing this stuff? This sounds exciting.
Yeah, I think for me, it's when you know, like when you see, you finally get through to a kid, right? Because they all want to act tough and kind of keep that like that bad of the bone persona, if that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah. And you can't be a tough guy with a 5-year-old smiling at you. That's not possible.
Right. Yeah. So last year, I was helping the quote unquote bad kid school. So these kids. We're pretty much court ordered to go to this school, and this school is set up.
That's not good.
Yeah, so it's set up. The kids live on campus. A lot of kids don't have parents, or the parents are in jail or strung out on drugs. So kids come. Yeah, they come from really tough homes. And last year, I asked the class. There was probably about 15 kids in there. They're anywhere from maybe like 16 to 20.
Uh-huh.
And so I asked the class and said, "What do you guys?" What are you guys planning on doing when you leave, when you graduate? Right. And this one guy was just trying to be a little smart aleck, and he's like, "I don't know, man. Probably end up back in jail."
Oh, he was in jail already. He was a little punk kid, huh?
Yeah, and so I was able to kind of talk with him like that, and I'm like, you know, that's not cool. Like the rest of the class laughed because they thought it was funny.
Right, right.
And I'm like, that's not cool. That's not okay. And so after everyone left, I went up to him, and I'm like, "Look, dude, like you just, you know, accept the fact that you're probably just going to end up back in jail. Like, why is that?"
Right.
And he kind of got a little choked up, you know, and he's like,
sure.
You know, this is all I know. He's like, I don't know how to. So I was able to really talk to him and be like, "Look, man, you could break that.
His tough bravado was a little cry for help.
Right. Yes. Yeah. And I think a lot of times, a lot of people write kids off in general because they see that. Where they say, you know, this kid's been in and out of jail. You know, this guy told me, this kid in particular, I think he was like 17, when he's been in and out of jail since he was 13 years old.
Yeah, see, I think the people that are that come off the toughest, really, they're the softest on the inside, and they're trying to just protect that.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. Yeah. Absolutely. And I think it's just about learning how to, a lot of people want to, they see that and they get mad. They're like, oh, this kid's just been a little punk kid, or he's been a little smart aleck, instead of really taking the time to say, no, this kid is hurting. How can we help him versus just push him away?
That's right, because that's the only way they can communicate is that being a little rough or being snotty or any of that stuff. But really, it's just they just don't have anybody to talk to.
Yeah, no, I agree. So it's something that's man, it's very, very close to me. And Ashley Hormer, I think you say your name, Hormer, Horner?
Uh-huh.
She's doing some really, really incredible stuff.
Not only
just for you, but people coming out of abused homes, and it's really good to see that because I think it's something that's really needed. And it's really easy, man, like to get in our own worlds, you know? Like, I have a great life. I have a beautiful wife. I have two beautiful kids, and my life is great.
Right.
So it's easy to kind of get into, like, this is my life. So, but you have to remember, like, there's so many other people out there who are in really, really bad situations.
A lot of people are in bad situations, and you know, a lot of times they just don't know how to get help. So it's good that you do that. That's awesome.
Yeah. So it's super, super, super important too.
Oh, crap. I got to go. This was really great. I enjoyed this.